Productivity applications have been vastly growing in price, and as you can imagine, costs have increased, but also the range of opportunity in the market. Today, we're going to be looking at an application that's going to cost $400 per year versus an application that costs just $27. These are similar in experience, and we're going to explore the core differences between them, as well as teach you some of the most valuable lessons about how to pick the best one for you. So welcome back, folks. It is Francesco here, and we are going to be diving into one of the most interesting topics in productivity is pricing. And we're going to be looking at two vastly different priced applications, but similar in nature to some extent. So welcome back, and let's roll into today's video. Today's video is sponsored by Toolfinder. We actually run Toolfinder. It helps you find the best productivity tools. You can find it linked below and search our wide variety of productivity tools, our guides, news, resources, and so much more if you want to explore. And also, we got a brand new newsletter which runs weekly, which dives into naturally the best of the breed and will keep you updated with productivity software. So it's my first video back from paternity. Well, I'm still on paternity. So if I look a little bit rough, take that into consideration. So let's dive into these two applications. Now, we've picked two applications that are fairly similar in nature, a task management application in the likes of Motion. Yes, Motion, not Notion. And the other one being TickTick, which has been a long-standing to-do list application which rivaled the likes of Todoist. And they are vastly different in pricing. $34 if you were to go with the monthly pricing for Motion for an individual account, which equates to just over $400 per year if you're going with that pricing. And looking at, for example, TickTick, which has a £2.50 at least in the UK pricing per month, which is a little lower than £27 for the whole year, which is fairly impressive. So I want to break these down in terms of three key areas: features, build quality and speed, and finalizing it with value. And I think hopefully, at least, you'll get some takeaways from looking at both of these applications in a bit more detail and exploring the core differences, but also some of the lessons that you might be able to apply to picking your next application. So if you look at Motion, first off, Motion is incredibly well designed and produced. And formerly, it was not available on desktop or mobile, but it actually had released that recently. But the application itself, when you look at it, it looks more like a fully fledged application to the extent where you're going, okay, this isn't just designed for somebody at home that's making grocery lists. This is an application that has projects, it has Kanban, it has advanced task management, calendar AI in there, and also a booking and scheduling function. So the application itself, it actually presents itself as a really clean looking experience and brings together all of these features that are going to be used by probably working professionals and those who are quite time intensive, who are in a lot of meetings, or potentially need to look at high level urgency items and need that almost stability with AI to be able to organize stuff around. Now, if you compare that to the likes of TickTick, now TickTick in its nature is a lightweight to-do list application, but it does have some great functionality. For example, being able to organize your inbox next 7 days, today, and using lists as well. In the premium, which is priced at what we mentioned at $27, that is actually inclusive of something called Calendar View, which allows you to see it in month, week, and day view, allowing you to plan and block much like you would in Motion. It also has some other additional functions like a habit tracker in it and a really good mobile and desktop applications that have been in the wild for some time now. So in nature, these applications are fairly similar, but in features, you can see that Motion goes incredibly much more in depth when you look at the strength of the features. For example, being able to plan a project, add lots of tasks and add lots of context to tasks is incredibly different to what you get in TickTick. Also, the ability to arrange stuff in the calendar is vastly different as well because it utilizes artificial intelligence to reorganize sessions for you. Now, this isn't necessarily beating on TickTick. they do offer some fantastic experience when it comes to general functionality. And having a habit tracker in there is also a bonus that you don't get inside of Motion. And they've also made this almost very much a personal application in nature, so you can't begin to share it with other people. So when you're looking at features of productivity applications, one of the lessons that I want to introduce you to, lesson one, is needs. Evaluate your needs before researching your productivity application. It's really important to get like a core list of things that really matter to you, whether that's 5 or 7 features that really just are no-brainers that your application needs before you do the research. For example, booking scheduling, if you were to look at TickTick, maybe it ticked all of the boxes for all the other stuff, but when it comes to that, Motion is probably going to offer that for you or another application in that similar space. So making sure you really evaluate the needs that you have. And another really popular tip that I always recommend is when you're writing out your needs list, is actually going, what hasn't worked in the past? Like, for example, if I've used Trello, why didn't I like Trello? Why didn't I get on with Trello? And really establishing some of the lessons from that so that you can apply it to future choices and research that you do. The next thing about these applications is build quality and speed. Now, to be honest, TickTick is really well designed. It's very easy to use, and it actually comes with a sense of cleanness. The design is really well, and its speed is good. But when you compare the speed of a $400 application, it's definitely a lot different. I find that Motion and applications like, for example, VimCal, AkiFlow, to be considerably faster than those that have been developed with a lower price in mind. And I think that's probably because there's a lot more focus on and a lot more budget to be able to spend on faster platforming underneath and things like that. But it's something to consider when you're using these every single day. Now, to be honest, at the common eye, you won't probably notice a huge amount of difference in speed between TickTick and Motion. But at the same time, it's something to note when it comes to utilizing the application. A lot of people have found that applications like Evernote have recently been stability and have always had some stability issues. So it's really important. Lesson number two is to look at the speed, quality, and bring that together and really try and establish good knowledge about it. And you can do that through reading user reviews, but you can also do that through testing out the application in a free trial and really try and throw up a lot of issues at it. Like, for example, open up a load of tabs, open up a load of applications and see what the speed is like once you're doing that. But you can definitely see in a $400 productivity application compared to a $27, the speed is a lot faster in terms of the build quality and function. So finally, is a sort of combination between the both. It's features combined with build quality and speed, and they really establish something called value. The value of each application is sort of like an equation to some extent. It's features divided by build quality features plus build quality divided by price, and that will probably give you the value of the item. I failed maths in school and at university, so at the same time I'm just making this equation up, but it will give you an understanding of, okay, if the features are good and the build quality is good, and if I divide that by price, what is the output for this? So for example, with something like Motion, yes, you do have some pretty decent features and the build quality is good, but divide it by the price and I think you get a lower score in terms of value than you do with something like TickTick. I think the value of TickTick in a package and pricing is actually considerably better than something like Motion. But of course, that's really differentiated between the person who's using it. For example, if you considerably get on well with Motion and it's in your budget, that is going to be good for you because then the value doesn't really matter as much. But that's just something to note. Budget is something that people always ignore with productivity applications, and it's really important because you need to know where you spend your money. I think it's Rami Sethi who does a book about how to teach yourself to be rich. One of the lessons from it, skimming through all of that, is the importance of picking the things you want to spend your money on. For example, I love going to the coffee shop and I don't mind spending money towards it. But for example, I don't know, buying really, really expensive clothing is not something that's really valuable to me. So I don't spend a lot of money on that. So it's really important to be able to establish what you like in your system and how that relates to productivity is very simply, I've got my to-do list app, I've got my notes taken app, calendar app, and you look at them and you go, how am I going to weight my monetary input to them? Maybe you're not paying for all of them. Maybe you are, but it's really important. Okay, I'm going to spend 60% of my money in that budget on a to-do list application and 10 on the other ones. That doesn't account to 100. 2020. But you get the idea. You're picking the ones that work best for you. It's going to be different for everyone. And budget is really important when picking a productivity application. So what have we learned today? Well, we've learned a lot of different things. Let's summarize it really quickly. Now, it's important to look at needs before you do your research. The second thing is to make sure that you look at the build quality and really be able to establish the value that that has in mind. And also take a look at the budget before you jump in with a productivity application. These are all really fundamental things and can help you pick the best productivity apps. So that was fun. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Again, this video was sponsored by Toolfinder, which you can find linked below. Toolfinder is our place to find productivity applications. And you can join the newsletter as well, which is every 2 weeks. And I think you'll thoroughly enjoy it. So thanks very much, folks. Do subscribe if you're new. Comment below with your thoughts, and I'll see you all very, very soon. Cheerio, folks.